Hi, and welcome everyone to what we are now calling the drafting table. We don't have quite... this is the table, this table right here. We don't quite have the setup to have as much room as we'd like, but we're here, so yay.
Yay!
And with the chat being monitored, and something that I couldn't have done without the help of, honestly... the guy who runs the first Twitch stream I ever subscribed to, Paul from Loading Ready Run, apparently put all of the... I shouldn't say apparently. He put up all the instructions for how to do a card recognizer onto a stream, and so we are going to be doing that, because I always liked the setup that Tap Tap Concede has, in that they have a card recognizer, and now we have a card recognizer, so this camera's for us, but this camera over here is for cards. So
Red is apparently trying to eat me.
This is the first official episode of the drafting table.
Yay!
The drafting table, everybody, is where we talk about magic cards.
Yes. And
what is the topic for today?
I realized that the most suitable topic for today was the cards that shouldn't be, the silly cards, the cards that have pushed magic into areas it wasn't meant to go. Namely, the Unsets and Future Sight, as well as the Holiday cards. Oh. But before we do that, we are going to crack a pack, so Red's going to roll our spin down.
Yay!
And Mikella's going to count from the front of the box.
I got
that's
20.
Oh, well, that's very fitting, because 20 is the pack of Unstable.
Gimme.
So, let me set up the recognizer to recognize Unstable cards. And that was better than we could have planned for, honestly. I'm really glad you didn't roll a 1, because I bought one pack of Homelands for when we fumble that. Mikella, can you put the pack of Conspiracy into the 20 slot? Or did you just take one at the back? You put the extra Unstable pack. Okay, so, our first card, because Unstable introduced some weird mechanics. Our first is the Augment card Humming, which, let's see if it'll take that. There we go.
Sucks for me.
There's Humming. Humming has no mana cost because it is an augment. It is a white. Augment cost is 3 and a white. With it gives the creature its augmenting flying. +2/+3. I plan on buying a whole set of these so we can draft this when on two scoops.
I got a shiny.
Alright, so next is a Beeble. I love Beebles. So here is our Beeble. There we go. Blurry Beeble. he is an artifact creature cyborg Beeble for 1 blue, a 1/1. Blurry, this creature can be blocked only if defending player was wearing glasses as it was passed. So, Red and I are at a slight disadvantage with this card. Because Mikella would be able to block this, but we wouldn't.
Yeah.
Yep, he sure is blurry.
Whenever Blurry
it's
Beeble deals combat damage... we are super quiet. We are trying to fix that. It's the microphone's fault.
Hello!
Jesus
ow.
Christ.
Part of that is the microphone we're using. It has an issue with being quiet, and I'm trying to fix that. So, let me try doing this real quick. I'm going to mute us. That'll make us quieter, but maybe we'll fix it in the long run. There, hopefully that helps a little bit. I have no idea what you did.
So as you know...
No. next up...
we were talking gibberish and pantomiming that we were talking, sorry.
So this is a host.
I wasn't.
Host cards. First off, it's a wild crocodile, 1 and a green for 1/1. Host creature crocodile. When this creature enters the battlefield, search your library for a basic land card, reveal it, put it in your hand, then shuffle it. I'm going to show this to Red and Mikella. So if I played my wild crocodile, and then I pay 3 and a white.
Okay. It's a humming crocodile.
Now it's a humming crocodile with flying.
Oh my god.
It's a 3/4, and whenever you attack with 2 or more creatures, you can search your library for a basic land card, reveal it, put it in your hand, then shuffle your library.
Cool.
Because that's how augments and hosts work.
Well, damn, I got a few of those.
Yeah, that was a theme with this set. Next up, we have
the crocodile. I was humming and then I went.
The Chipper Chopper. Three and a blue for a 1/1 flying cyborg rigger. When Chipper Chopper enters the battlefield, you may sacrifice another artifact. If you do, put 2+1/+1 counters on Chipper Chopper, and it assembles a contraption, which you're going to have to see contraptions in a moment. We have Finders Keepers, a perfectly named sorcery. Destroy target creature, then assemble a contraption for 5 and a black.
Yep.
So it's removal plus get a contraption, which is very relevant to Unstable.
Yep.
What, Appy?
Hi, Appy!
We have the Feisty Stegosaurus. 4 and a red for a 2/1. When this creature enters the battlefield, roll a 6-sided die. This creature deals damage equal to the result to target creature and opponent controls. So you could, of course, make a humming Stegosaurus.
They found my birth family.
Oh, that's cool!
Oh, that's fun! You found your birth family!
Yay!
Fantastic!
Yay.
We have the Nomade Engine and host artifact creature. When this creature enters the battlefield, create a 1/1 colorless gnome artifact creature token. It's a 2/2 for 4. Apparently, Appy has a sister.
Ooh,
good
cool.
for Appy. Happy about that.
It looks like Megamind.
Low Blobber. It's a gun that shoots brains. Equipped creature has tap. This creature deals 1 damage to target player. Roll a 6-sided die. On a 5 or higher, untap it. Equip 2. Time for you to meet the brains of this operation. The big idea. We have Beast in Show, which this is a card with variants.
Yeah.
This is one of the variants. It is...
Also, your mic is super quiet.
We are fully aware of the quietness problem.
We're trying!
We can't make the mic any louder.
This is as loud as it gets. We're sorry.
The mic that is louder has a staticky problem right now.
Yeah, it does.
Okay, so Beast in
Our
Show...
Our bad!
Beast and Show is a 6/4 with Trample that is made up of 6/6s with Trample from other sets.
Yes, you can just hit it.
Yeah, we're aware of that. It's not picking up as well as we'd like.
Also, for those who...
I mean, I guess we could turn up
the
gain.
The
sorry.
We're sorry.
I mean, we could, yeah, we turned up the gain, but I don't want to turn it much higher or else it's just going to feedback everything.
Yeah, sorry!
Anyway, next card. Overt Operative.
Try.
It's me, I'm aware of that. Because the mic's over here and the camera's over there. Actually, that might work. Just move the mic over here. Whoa!
What the hell did you do?
I moved it off kilter.
It is our first show for the drafting game.
Technically second, but it's the new mic. That's a bigger issue.
Also not looking good today.
Hey!
That's not what it says at all.
Oh, what does it say?
You're combining two messages by trying to read the chat.
Oh, also Red's looking... Thank you! I am! My hair's very nice today.
You already read that one.
Oh. What was the one before
that? That not to look away from the camera. Anyway.
What?
Christ. The Overt Operative, a Ninja Rigger, a 2/3 with Menace. Whenever it deals combat damage, it assembles.
Cool.
Hopefully we're going to get a contraption soon so we can show you what assembling is.
I have a couple.
Hammerfest Boomtacular, an enchantment. Whenever you cast a spell with the Goblin Explosioneer's watermark, because watermarks matter. Yes, watermarks are very important. You deal 2 damage to target creature or player. Is that fun?
Yeah.
And the 3-headed goblin. 3 and a red for a 3/3 with triple strike. It deals first strike, regular strike, and last strike combat damage.
Cool.
You just want to get through these, don't you?
Yeah.
Do you have to excuse yourself?
No.
Okay. So, our mountain, the lands for the set are kind of weird. I like the mountain, but I hate the forest.
Okay.
I'm glad we got the mountain. The mountain's real cool.
No!
What are you doing?
Red's trying to eat me.
So, contraptions. We have Guest List, which is a Legion of Dastardly Doom one, I want to say. Whenever you crank Guest List, because if you notice the back has cranks.
Oh,
Target creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn, where X is the number of creature cards in its controller's graveyard.
Yeah.
All the ones with the same watermark turn into a big picture together.
Cool!
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so like, these would go this way.
Oh, hey! That's right, they do, that's cool.
Yeah, because we got the, they're both Legion of Dastardly Doom.
Awesome.
Ones. And if you get all 9, it makes a picture on your sheet.
Oh.
And we have the division table. Whenever you crank division table, target player loses 2 life. very fun of that. What's our token?
I'm keeping it.
Let's see if the token works.
I want to keep it.
Does it recognize tokens? It's not liking tokens. We got a vampire token.
It's
nice.
Pretty. It's shiny. I want to keep it.
It's a 2/2 vampire with flying. Anyway, so for today's discussion, which I am actually going to move this to the side, and we're going to turn off the capture camera for that.
Oh.
Well, we're not completely getting rid of the card recognizer.
Hmm.
What we are doing, though, is I have a couple things open first. So we're going to start with the first unset and work our way forward.
Okay.
We're not going to do every single card.
Okay.
Because that would take for freaking ever.
Days
and days. But what we are going to do is we're going to do the more fun ones of each set.
Okay.
And of course, the best way to start with that is, I would say Ashnod's Coupon is one of my favorites, and it's the first one in the set, which is very helpful. Sacrifice Ashnod's Coupon, target player gets you a drink. Errata, you pay for any costs of the drink.
Can I play that one now? I want some scotch.
Mikella, can you go handle that?
All right,
so Mikella's gonna go get. Mikella's gonna go get some scotch.
That or a little. Like a little. You know my scotch glass? I think so.
Yes!
And, like, I find it funny that the first 5 are, are 5 I had already picked out we were gonna do.
Yay!
Then we have the big furry monster, which was your first split card.
Cool.
This is the left half.
Oh my god.
You had to have both halves to play it.
Aww.
You must play both BEFM cards to put Leaves Play Sacrifices the other. BFM can be blocked only by 3 or... It was big, really big, no bigger, no more. Look, we're talking about Krakens and... and then the other half of Big Furry Monster shows that he is worth a black. I want to say it's 13 black.
Jesus Christ!
For a $99.99.
Oh my god!
BFM into play if either BFM card. More creatures. Then that, even bigger, keep going, more. Dreadnoughts for jewelry, it was big. Arnakernead, Sky Knight.
Oh my god!
So remember, Unglued was meant to be a pack you would add to any other draft to make it funnier.
Yeah.
We have Blacker Lotus.
Blacker Lotus!
Which has the joke of people who would tear their Black Lotus in half just to show how much money they had.
Man.
This one is tap. Tear Blacker Lotus into pieces. Add 4 mana of any one color to your mana pool. Play this ability as a mana source. Remove the pieces from the game afterwards.
Damn.
So there's your Black Lotus, and there's your Blacker Lotus in the background. And then the Bronze Calendar. It's a colander. Which is a joke on, there was a lemur that they had drawn a lemur.
Your drink.
Yes.
We are.
Which scotch is this?
The light one that was in the box.
Okay.
So we're jumping a couple of these because we're not gonna do every one. Bronze calendar I just put in because it's a colander and that's just a funny joke.
Yep.
We have the Burning Cinder Fury of Crimson Chaos Fire, which is sideways. You'll notice. So one thing I am gonna do, let's see if we can transform this.
Rotate 90 degrees.
It's 3 and a red. Whenever any player taps a card, that player gives control of that card to an opponent at end of turn.
Okay.
If a player does not tap any non-land cards during his or her turn, Burning Cinder Fury of Crimson Chaos Fire deals 3 damage to that player at end of turn. So this is hot potato.
Hot potato, hot potato.
You were playing hot potato with this in by tapping cards to try to pass it to your opponent. in the hope they wouldn't get something. Cardboard Carapace, a card that cared how many copies of this card you owned that wasn't in the game. What kind of scotch is it?
It's Glenfiddich. I think this is probably the 12 year.
Okay.
It was the one that looked open.
Well, we'd opened both of them, so.
It looked like this one was open.
It was the open scotch.
They're both open!
That's the important part. It's the scotch that was open.
If it's the lighter one, it's probably the 12 year.
I can go get the bottle. The bottle's empty now.
If it's empty, it's not the 12 year.
Hi Archcon, hi Seaberry.
Hi Archcon!
So yeah, this
I'm
one.
I'm drinking!
So, for each other Cardboard Carapace card you have with you, Enchanted Creature gets +1/+1. But it only counts cards that aren't in the game, so you would have to carry a stack of these in your pocket.
Sweet.
To make it worthwhile. Censorship. It's censored. When censorship comes into play, choose a beep word.
I almost just.
Whenever any beeping
beep.
Player says the chosen
beep.
Word, censorship deals 2 damage to him or her.
Yay, drinking.
The illustrator's been beeped too. Chaos confetti.
Cool.
Oh no.
Pour in a tap, tear chaos confetti
story,
into pieces. Throw the pieces into the playing area from a distance of at least 3 feet or 5 feet. Destroy each card in play that a piece touches. Remove the pieces from the game afterwards. So there was an urban legend that somebody had Chaos Amulet, I think it was. There was some card called Chaos something. And the way that card would work is you would hold it up like this over the field and drop it. And every card that it landed on was destroyed.
Cool.
So if you just, like right now, it would destroy nothing because that card fell to the side.
Yeah.
But like if it landed here, it would get rid of all these.
Cool.
Okay. And the urban legend goes that a kid was at a tournament and went, well, wait, I'm going to use Chaos Orb. Chaos Orb, that's it. Mm. And he just started shredding it and dropped the pieces on the mat. And his opponent called the judge, and the judge went, well, it doesn't say you can't.
Okay.
Your chair came completely off.
Shit.
There are no screws in your chair.
There were. There's one screw in
there. There aren't now.
Shit.
Maybe go get a folding chair and we never use this chair again.
Sounds good. I can't even put it back in.
So, Red died. Red seems fine, actually.
Don't drink in stream, guys. Well, and there goes the list.
Don't drink in chair.
Motherfuck.
That is good scotch. Bit of a tablecloth after.
I'm sorry. To be fair, it did fall.
You got it on one card, and I wiped it off. It's all good.
Okay.
Which card? The Beeble got drunk.
Oh, no! Don't drink in Beeble, people.
Don't Beeble people in general. People don't like being Beebled.
Thankfully, it didn't get on the phone. That's the important part.
Yes. Thankfully, phones are safe.
Entertaining for stream.
Right.
Well, adding to the list of things that your Patreon and Twitch money supports, getting Red a new chair.
I actually have one in my room that's better, it's just I like that one. Or liked that one.
I will be right back.
Why do you love me all of a sudden, Abby? Anyway. I appreciate the love, but I'm wondering. So, another one we're going to throw in there, just because I think you'd enjoy it, is Charm School.
Hmm.
You had to choose a color and balance Charm School on your head. Prevent all damage to you of the chosen color. If Charm School falls off your head, sacrifice Charm School.
What the fuck? So you have to... Do I just have to keep it in?
Yeah, and
okay.
You keep it there and you have protection from whatever color you said. You've lost your protection. I'm sorry if you're not hearing anything, man.
Premium proper.
We're having a problem with audio. You're going to have to crank us way up.
Yeah, sorry.
If we yell, we will try to warn you.
Yeah.
Because apparently the mic is just really quiet.
It's a very quiet mic. Sorry about that. Anyway, moving on. There was a chicken.
That was spilled on this table.
There was a chicken cycle. This is Chicken a la King, who is a lord card.
Oh my god.
Except he's a special lord card, in that you have to, whenever you roll a 6 on a 6-sided die, put a +1/+1 counter on each chicken in play.
Hmm.
Like chicken egg. Shit. Which, when you roll a 6, it turns into a chicken. We have the clam session. I'm not going to do the rest of the clams.
Don't know if I'm hearing anything, Tootsieberry.
I know, we've addressed that already.
Yep.
No, I mean, I address Seaberry specifically.
Okay.
Just, you keep addressing the chat after I've addressed the chat. Alright. So, clam session, which, during your upkeep, you have to sing 6 words of a song. It'll be fine. This isn't like an ancestral tablecloth or anything.
Okay.
We got this when we moved in.
We have Clam I Am, who has nothing funny about him himself, except that he is a Dr. Seuss card. But he's not written like a Dr. Seuss card, so he's not as great as I wish. I just love the art.
I like how everyone's telling me how good I look today. Thank you!
Yeah, we're getting that a lot. We have the Elvish impersonators.
That's what they're telling you.
Elvish impersonators.
It's an Elvis elf!
Yep.
Oh my god, that's great!
The first full art lands were in Unglued. Very important.
That is pretty cool.
I'm trying to see what else there was. There's a couple other weird ones in here that I really want to bring up. Handcuffs. Target player keeps both hands in contact with each other. If he or she does not, sacrifice handcuffs, and that player sacrifices 3 cards.
Arista-sha.
Sorry,
Girl Scout Camp.
Yep.
Also... any weird song that passes my lips is probably a camp song.
Unglued was also the origin of tokens.
Cool.
Without it, there wouldn't have been one. Here we go. The Infernal Spawn of Evil.
It's a rat.
It's a little
mouse. It's a little mousey. They purposely picked the wrong art. We have.
Dude, we have.
Oh, or he's telling Seaberry.
Okay.
Sorry.
We're just tired of saying
it. Oh, here we go. Look at me on the DCI.
Oh my god, that's great!
You understand the DCI's rigorous decision-making process. He's drinking and blindfolded and playing darts. These ones are fun. We have Paper Tiger.
Ooh.
Who?
Oh my god, is that an actual origami tiger?
Yes. And he cannot be, he makes it so rock lobsters cannot attack or block. And as you could probably guess, rock lobsters... have a similar effect on scissor lizards.
It was Alan and Dale?
Oh, the Chicken a la King is Alan and Dale, yes.
I just watched that today. Or was it yesterday? It was yesterday.
And then
you
we have our
here.
Scissor lizards. Which that one wasn't a pun, it just rhymed.
It's so cute! We looked at lizards today. They were adorable.
We went to a PetSmart. It was fun.
One of them was red and I wanted it.
We didn't have, they didn't have any kitties.
This one's great. This one actually got turned into a real card. The Cheese Stands Alone.
Oh my god.
Which was changed into, it was made into a serious card. So there was no cheese references. But it was basically, if you control no cards and play... other than the Cheese Stands Alone, and you have no cards in your hand, you win the game.
God damn! I want it!
And then a cycle that was very important to finish.
Yep.
This one started it. Timmy the Power Gamer. 2 and a green for a 1-1. For four, put a creature into play from your hand. So he basically changes all mana costs to four.
Huh.
Or less.
That's not bad.
Right. And then perhaps my favorite out of all of them here. The ultimate nightmare of Wizards of the Coast customer service. Called as such because it costs red mana.
Okay.
The art is clearly a red effect.
Yeah.
It is a blue bordered card.
Oh no.
With a black text box.
Oh.
I've been working on modern, or M15 format, unglued proxies for a cube, and I actually updated this one. One, so that it had a green color indicator as well, just to completely throw you off. And I also updated down here, because the flavor text was the old Wizards of the Coast helpline.
Yeah.
My proxy has the new Wizards of the Coast helpline. the card you were looking for, Skippy, is Chicken a la King.
Don't knock that over again.
No. No! It's almost empty, I swear. I'm just...
So that was unglued. There were a lot more cards on unglued that we've just skipped over, but...
Oh god, that burned.
That's for time constraints. So after unglued came Unhinged.
Yeah?
Unhinged...
Okay, now I'm warm. I think it's probably the scotch.
Gee, you think?
I'm actually not that drunk.
Unhinged had a couple of interesting ones.
I would have been way more drunk if I'd actually been drunk. But I fell over.
However, keep in mind that Unhinged is more juvenile. So, for example, a lot of jokes about donkeys. This is the Asquatch.
I didn't know about that one.
We have the ass whooping.
Yay!
Badass.
Oh my god! I've seen that card before somewhere!
We have a couple of these.
Oh, okay.
Cheap ass. was originally going to be called tight ass, apparently. But they found out that meant two things. The red got dumbass. And of course, as you could probably figure out, what blue got.
Smartass?
Blue got, if I can find it, smartass. And, where was green?
Didn't we already do green?
Badass.
Oh, badass. It's a sumo wrestling donkey, that's great.
And there was, of course, also the city of ass.
What?
It was a reference to another called City of Brass.
I'm really not that tootsie, okay?
Oh, we had B-I-N-G-O. Trample, whenever a player casts a spell, put a chip counter on its converted mana cost.
Oh my god.
B-I-N-G-O gets +9/+9 for each set of three numbers in a row with chip counters on them.
Oh, that's great.
It's whenever a player, so it can include you.
Ooh.
But Bingo does not count for his own two.
Oh, okay.
So, sorry. We have Blast from the Past, who is a bit of a weird one. In fact, hold up. Were there two versions? No, there's just one version of the art. It is a old bordered card, if you notice.
Yeah.
Or it's a classic shifted, which is something that happened in Time Shift. But you see that back there? Right up here. There's a little goblin on a time machine.
Oh.
Because it's a blast from the past. And he shows up again in Old Fogey.
Oh my god!
He crashed.
That's
behind
great.
A dinosaur. And both of those cards have effects that were out of print.
I'm pretty sure tipsy/drunk people say that every day. I'm not that tipsy. I'm always tipsy. At least I'm not.
At least I'm not Lala or Poe. this is Red Hot Hottie.
Oh my god!
For two and a red head. Two and a red red. Not two and a red head. For a 2/5 elemental. She is melting the text off the card. We had Richard Garfield, PhD.
Oh my god.
You may play cards as though they were other magic cards of your choice with the same mana cost.
Cool.
Rocket Powered Turbo Slug, he's going so fast he went through the flavor text. And
that's cool.
He blew up a lady's dress.
Sweet.
There was another very, very fun. Urza's Hot Tub, because there's a running joke after Urza got beheaded in the main story.
Yeah.
That in uncards he keeps popping up as a head. We will see that again later. The Mana Screw.
Mana Screw?
Well, because what is it when you can't draw any lands?
Your
mana screwed.
Yeah. I had that first time we ever played Magic on air.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It sucked. So hard.
I figured.
Like a Hoover vacuum.
Oh, this one's kind of weird. At the time, there was a message board on Wizards called Gleemax.
Yeah.
So this is Gleemax, the brain mascot of the message board. He costs 1,000,000 mana.
God damn!
Legendary artifact, you choose all targets for all spells and abilities. Help us, R&D under mental domination of alien brain and jar. Only chance, Gleemax's blatant disregard for flavor text. Send help. we have Fraction Jackson.
Man, St. Petersburg's new architect is a visionary.
I think they just got to the city of Ass. Which is showing me how far behind our stream is.
Damn!
No, because on our end it's still Fraction Jackson, which we just put up there.
That's weird.
So I think that's just him. But anyway, so we have Fraction Jackson.
Neat.
Two and a green. Green and a tap. Return target card with that 1/2 on it from your graveyard to your hand.
Okay.
Because here's the thing. There were a lot of 1/2 cards. Like this one. She's a 1 and a 3 and a half. we had Cheaty Face. You may sneak Cheaty Face into play at any time without paying for it. But if an opponent catches you right away, that player may remove Cheaty Face from the game.
Oh, that's messed up.
You'll also notice he actually costs 3 mana.
Yeah.
He stole the water drop out of his mana symbol. this one's fun. This one's very fun. Carnivorous Death Parrot. Flying, at the beginning of your upkeep, sacrifice Carnivorous Death Parrot unless you say it's flavor text. Save a kill spell to deal with this guy.
Now, why was it called that?
Because there was a cycle of cards.
Yeah.
Including deal damage. And all of these had, if you said any of the words in their name, they came back from the graveyard to your hand.
Oh, cool!
But it's whenever an opponent says it. So if they had Carnivorous Death Parrot, and they said his flavor text, you could call back deal damage, creature guy. there's a couple other ones, I gotta find them in here.
Oh, my toes, why does it itch? Oh, itchy.
I'm going to find the other ones here.
Okay.
And I'm saving one of my favorite ones for the end here. Oh, we have the Infernal Spawn of the Infernal Spawn of Evil. Yes. Kill Destroy.
Kill Destroy! It's a squirrel!
And they're trying to kill it with everything they can.
Yes!
Squirrel!
Save a kill spell to deal with this guy.
Scotch tastes the same coming up as it did going down.
Oh.
That's good to know.
Oh, save life.
Yay. Which is a Baywatch character.
And spell counter.
That's awesome.
And if you play those in a certain order, it's playing unhinged. And there's, I will find it later and like post it in the comments, but there was a limerick in those 5 cards.
Yeah?
And if you put them in the right order, it was a limerick.
Cool.
There is... Oh, this one I always get a... Oh, let's do this one first.
Okay.
The Phyrexian Librarian.
Oh, God.
Which, due to me misreading an eBay listing, I own 127 of these. It was 139. We've been slowly getting rid of them.
Seriously, though, 130?
139.
God damn, man, why?
Because I misread the eBay listing.
What did it say?
It was a assorted lot.
Yeah?
And it was listing off the cards, and I didn't read that it had said that 129 of the 360 cards were that card.
Why did they have so many of that card?
You know what? Some questions are better left unasked.
Well,
what does
it
do?
Wait. Go back to the Phyrex and Librarian.
It's three and a black for a 3/3 with flying and trample.
Cool.
At the beginning of your upkeep, remove the top card of your library from the game face up and balance it on your body.
Oh!
When a balance card falls or touches another balance card, sacrifice Phyrexian Librarian.
Damn. What if I made just an entire deck of nothing but those cards?
That would be illegal. You could only have four of them.
Aww.
We have,
I do like that one.
I do like this one. We have a copy of this, too. Our market research shows that players like really long card names, so we made this card to have the longest card name ever, Elemental.
This set is so freaking funny. Yes, it is.
Yeah, I love Unhinged. Wait till you get to Unstable. It's not quite as over the top,
yeah,
but it's fun. Oh, this is another great one.
Holy mother of God!
This is Who, What, When, Where, Why.
Oh my God.
Split cards have come out in Magic recently before this.
Yeah.
Which are those cards that are two cards, and you can cast either side or both of them.
Yeah.
So this is a five-way split card.
Jesus Christ.
You can cast Who, What, When, Where, or Why. Or all of them. If you can afford them. But they're all different colors. And we can't see anything right now, because I'm pulling it up for all of us to see. If it'll load all the way. There we
go.
So, Who, X and a white, target player gains X life.
Oh my God.
What? Two and a red, destroy target artifact. When, two and a blue, counter target creature spell. That one's an instant. Oh, they're all instants.
Yeah.
Where, three and a black, destroy target land. Mm-hmm. Why, one and a green, destroy target enchantment.
God
damn.
That's five colors, right?
Yeah.
That would fit well in your dragon deck if
right?
Silver border was allowed.
Right?
Yeah. I'm going to do two more from this before we move on to Future Sight.
Cool.
One is the Water Gun Balloon Game. When Water Gun Balloon Game comes into play, each player puts a pop counter on a zero.
That's awesome.
When a pop counter, and they're here, if you notice.
Yeah.
When a pop counter, when they cast a spell, move the pop counter up to one. Whenever a player's pop counter hits five, that player puts a 5/5 pink giant teddy bear creature token into play.
That's
and resets all pop counters to zero.
That's fantastic.
Oh,
make some confetti out of them.
So it was this set that brought in the other colors outside of the five normal ones, right?
I think Unglued brought in brown and hazel mana. And this one brought in pink mana.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so technically you can have mana of any color that exists as a card.
Okay.
Gold doesn't count until Unstable.
Okay.
Because gold was your fill-in color for multicolor.
Okay.
All right. So you had the standard five, red, blue, black, red, green.
Yeah.
All right. And then you had colorless.
Yes.
For artifacts.
Yes.
There is a card in Unglued called Avatar of Myself. I believe it's in Unglued. Oh, no. It's in Unhinged. Unhinged brought it in, too. Mm-hmm. Avatar of Me. Two and a blue. Avatar of Me costs one more to play for each 10 years you've been alive. So for me, it is a four and a blue. In 3 years, it'll be a five and a blue.
Yeah.
Avatar of Me's power is equal
to
your height and feet. And its toughness is equal to your American shoe size. Round to the nearest half.
That's not good for me, because I'm the one with the smallest feet here.
Avatar of Me's color is the color of your eyes. So I would have a blue hazel avatar of me.
Tiny feet!
Red would have a blue avatar of me. Michaela would have a hazel avatar of me. I have some friends who would have a green avatar of me.
Wait, why would I have blue?
Because you have blue eyes.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I do.
You do?
Yes.
You should look at them more. It's a little difficult, though.
I do stare in the mirror a lot. I'm kind of like a parakeet that way.
I'm looking for the goblin time machine.
Tiny feet.
Before we... Okay.
The things that happen on the dressing table.
Apparently... Scotch and my feet.
Yep.
That's
somebody's fetish.
Right?
Here we go. Time machine for five mana. Tap, remove Time Machine and target non-token creature you own from the game. Return both cards to play at the beginning of your upkeep of your turn X of the next game you play with the same opponent, where X is the removed creature's converted mana cost.
What in the fuck?
So, for example, if I were to use, say, this Initiate's Companion, and I removed it, on turn two of our next game, the Time Machine and the Initiate's Companion both show up.
What in the fuck?
They travel to another time.
Jesus Christ!
It's fantastic. Alright, so, actually, before we go to Future Sight, we're gonna go to Holiday Cards.
You know what that would really suck if you used it with? That stupid hexproof dinosaur of yours that I hate.
Oh, you mean the best card? Yes.
I hate that card so much.
Well, the problem is I'm basically screwing myself over in that game.
Yeah.
Because I'm exiling it.
Yeah, all right. True.
So, these are the Holiday Cards.
Ooh.
I'm gonna do all of them because there's only, like, 8.
1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
There's 11. and we're going to start with Evil Presence.
It's late our time, so we can't do math as well.
Evil Presence, 2 and a black. Put a creature card from your hand into play under target opponent's control. That creature attacks each turn if able and always attacks its controller.
Cool.
The Fruitcake Elemental. 1 and a green for a 7/7. It is indestructible at the end of your turn. It deals 7 damage to you. For 3, target player gains control of Fruitcake Elemental. Gifts Given, which is a pun on Gifts Ungiven. Search target opponent's library for 4 cards with different names and reveal them. That player chooses 2 of those cards. Put the chosen cards into the player's graveyard and the rest into your hand.
Cool.
Then the player shuffles his or her library. That one's not as funny. Goblin Sleigh Ride. target creature control climbs onto Goblin Sleigh Ride. You slide them on their merry way. If the creature stayed on, it deals damage equal to its toughness to each other creature touched during the slide. So you go, woo, and push them across the table. Mishra's Toy Workshop.
Ooh.
Tap, add 3 to your mana pool. Spend this mana only on spells and abilities that put tokens onto the battlefield. Use toys to represent the tokens.
Yay. I like that.
Avatar of Me is dressed like the real Slim Shady. Naughty or Nice, which is a split card. Naughty is 1 and a black. Search another target player's library for a card and put that card into your hand.
That guy looks seriously creepy.
Then shuffle that player's library. He's over here. He ate a pie.
Okay, yeah, but in the Naughty card, super fucking creepy.
That's the point. 1 and a white, search your library for a card and put that into another target player's hand, then shuffle your library.
This reminds me of the discussion we were having earlier. Which I'm not gonna mention on camera.
Oh, yes, that one.
Damn, that took a while.
Season's Beatings.
I'm confused. I will need clarification after you're done.
We will clarify later.
Okay.
Family Gathering, each creature target player controls deals damage equal to its power to another random creature that player controls.
Okay.
Snow Mercy.
Yay!
Whenever a creature deals damage to you, put a globe counter on it. Tap, untap, tap, untap, tap.
Not mention on camera. Sounds like a good conversation. It was.
Tap all creatures with globe counters on them. So, you're tap, untap, tap, untap, tap to do it.
Okay.
They're in a snow globe. Warning, shake gently. Contents may cause choking, hypothermia, and or planar invasion.
Oh my god.
My favorite out of them, the Stalking Tiger.
Hidden Dragon.
That was Crouching Tiger.
Oh my god.
5 for a 3/3 artifact creature. Stalking Tiger enters the battlefield with a sealed magic booster pack under it. When Stalking Tiger deals combat damage to a player, unwrap the booster pack and put it in your hand.
Entire booster pack?
Yes.
That's some messed up shit.
Thopter Pi Network, a modification of Thopter Spy Network. Enchantment, at the beginning of your upkeep, if you're eating, create a 1/1 colorless Thopter artifact token with flying. Use food to represent the token. Whenever a creature token you control dies, if it's represented by food, eat it.
Oh my god. I would use popcorn.
Some disassembly required.
Reese's Christmas trees.
This is the new one. This is this year's.
Is there any excuse for a second?
To go get a Reese's Christmas tree?
No. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Black and
yes,
sacrifice a creature.
Okay.
Distribute the sacrifice creature's keyword
okay.
abilities among any other number of target creatures until the end of turn. If it's December, you gain one life for each of these keywords.
Wait, say that one more time.
So, you take every keyword that creature has and distribute them after you kill it to your other creatures, and if it's December, you get a life.
Kill it.
And also, I love that this part of, now all they needed was a holly, was a jolly, happy soul.
Jesus.
And the Yule Ooze. At the beginning of your upkeep, destroy another non-land permanent chosen at random, then put a number of +1/+1 counters on Yule Ooze equal to that permanent's converted mana cost. Red and a green, eat some food, regenerate the Yule Ooze. I love it. It loves having family for dinner.
Okay, that's creepy.
Oh yes, it is. Now, Future Set, we're not going to do a lot. We're going to do the Future Shifts, and that's it.
Okay.
Because this is basically the unset that never was.
Okay. Oh,
because every future shifted card that had a new ability,
mm-hmm.
they made an ability with the intention of it never coming back.
Aww.
And then the fans demanded they come back. So, for example, a guy you're going to see a little bit later, because this directly influenced the one we're about to do, Unstable. Steamflogger Boss. Also, notice how the future cards look.
Completely different.
I think this is how the magic cards of the future will look.
I like them. They look cool.
I know. I wish they'd actually done that. But I can see why they didn't, because the mana costs on the left is hard to deal with.
Mm.
Let's see here. Tarmogoyf. He actually came back around, I believe. He's Graveyards Matter. Street Wraith. Swamp Walk and Cycling. Two abilities that never... Well, Cycling came back.
Street race, I get
it. That's not really a pun. It's just a thing.
Mm.
It's a wraith on a street.
What are the circumstances that cause one of these to exist? Is, like, a fifth week.
Okay, so... Unglued came about because they wanted to make a set that was weird. And just a set... Well, they had the idea of Silver Border being the set that you're not allowed to use in a tournament. And so they decided, let's use that to make weird things. Unhinged came about because they want to do another one, which, you know, that's fine. That's fun. Future Sight came about because somebody wanted to do time travel bullshit and magic, and they thought this would be fun. And then you have Unstable, our next one, which apparently was 7 years of Mark Rosewater fighting with corporate to make it happen. So we're...
I'm not getting any more stuff.
No, that's not... No.
That sounded like you wanted more scotch.
No, I'm just... I'm gonna put this away. I'm fiddling with it.
Now, we already did some Unstable cards. The two big things to come out of Unstable was, one, the host and augment system, which you've already got to see a little bit of in... 1 second.
I'm way too goddamn perky tonight.
Okay.
I don't know what happened in between us driving and getting here. I've all of a sudden got all this energy.
So the biggest things that came out of Unstable
tired in the car.
Was the augment. Oh wait, I have to clear this. There we go. Undo this. There we go.
Hey, it's humming.
The augment cards, which you added on top of a host card. I'm getting surprisingly good at doing this without looking. And then also the contraptions. Which, was it here?
So you say that, and then immediately you have trouble doing it.
Yeah, because I ruined it for myself.
You jinxed yourself.
And this one was also Watermarks Matter. So the watermarks were a big deal. And there were some very fun ones in here that you got to do stuff with. This one was basically built around there being... 5 factions, though potentially a 6th faction.
Squirrels!
The squirrels with Squirrel Link.
Squirrel!
Now, a couple ones I'm going to do because they're just fantastic.
Yes. Squirrel?
No, I'm going to show some of the variants. First, we're going to start with Extremely Slow Zombie.
Okay.
Who has nothing to do with the rest of the set.
Yay! Extremely Slow Zombie.
I like Extremely Slow Zombie.
He is a 1-1. Sorry, he's a 1 and a black for a 3-3 with Last Strike. He deals all of his damage after everyone else has.
Okay.
He's slow.
Because he's extremely slow. Summer.
Oh my god.
Fall. Winter. And spring.
And if you read the flavor text on all of those as fast as...
Well,
I'll
also,
put
that's
it
the...
up there. It read... Brains.
But if you also notice, it's animated. Watch his arm.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even realize that!
I did.
He's slowly reaching for you. And of course, my favorite part is this one, that somebody had to have walked up to him and put on a hat at Christmas in order for that to make sense, or that in spring there are some birds making a nest in his jaw. Yeah.
The unset's awesome. They're great.
Oh, also, Full Art Lands.
I have a question.
Went super full art, yes.
What if you have all four of those in a deck?
Uh-huh.
And those are the only ones you have on the field. Which one goes first?
They all go at the same time.
Okay.
Last Strike happens after the other damage has been done.
Okay.
Just like First Strike happens.
So the process of damage goes First Strike, Regular Strike, Last Strike.
Got it.
And if you have double strike, you count in first and in normal. And if you have triple strike, you count in all three.
Cool.
Garbage Elemental, which originally was going to have 400 variants.
Holy crap.
They talked Mark Rosewater down to 6.
They're like, no.
Old Mark,
my
no.
Goodness. No. No.
And if you notice, they're all the same cost with different effects and different powers and toughnesses.
God damn.
All the same art. They're the same card. Oh, but some are riggers and some aren't.
Okay.
Garbage Elemental's fun. We also have... This one's great. Go to jail!
Go to jail.
Go directly to
for
jail.
For one white...
Pass go. Do not collect $200.
For one white, you go to jail. Exile target creature to an opponent controls until go to jail leaves the battlefield. And it, where's my water? I had it. Here it is. Beginning of your upkeep, the player gets to roll 2 6-sided dice. If they roll doubles, you get rid of go to jail.
Because that's how you get rid of, that's how you get out of jail in Monopoly.
Yep.
Just in case those who don't know how to play Monopoly.
Another one of the, let's play another game like B-I-N-G-O's.
Where's the little tiny pencil?
Because I don't trust students with normal size ones. Hangman! For 1 black and a 1/1, as Hangman enters the battlefield, secretly note a word with 6 to 8 letters. 1, target player who doesn't control Hangman guesses the noted word or an unguessed letter in that word. If he or she guesses wrong, put a +1/+1 counter on Hangman. Any player may activate this ability. When a player guesses all of the noted word or all of the letters, sacrifice Hangman.
What if they don't?
Then you just keep adding +1/+1s to him.
Yay! So find a 6 to 8 letter word that's really, really hard to spell.
I was told dexterous is the way to go.
Ooh.
Hydrodoodle.
What in the fuck is it?
It's an XX green green 00. As Hydrodoodle enters the battlefield, roll X 6-sided dice. Hydrodoodle enters the battlefield with a number of +1/+1 counters on it equal to the total of those results.
So Skippy says it's not like he would have moved to stop it.
That's true.
I'm assuming he's talking about the zombie.
The zombie putting it on. We have the Ineffable Blessing.
Ooh.
Which each of these change. They all have different things.
Okay.
You have no idea what your Ineffable Blessing is going to be.
No. Okay.
Each one cares about a different thing. The Infinity Elemental.
What in the fuck?
He is 4 red, red, red for a card with infinity 5. has infinity power and 5 toughness.
God damn! It's so infinite that its flavor text says
yeah. It's recursive. Sadly, there's not a code on Oracle that makes it just go on forever, which I wish there was.
Aww.
Oh, Kindslaver, this is fun. It's a variant of Mindslaver.
Huh.
But it's also a beer hat.
It is!
That you get to pick somebody who's not in the game to control you. You.
Different levels of trash with the garbage elemental.
Yes. Yes, it is. It is different levels of trash. You also have commanders of the different armies, like Mary O'Kill, who can turn into her killbots, Doctor Doom style.
Cool.
Oh, here's a great one. Novellamental. They are 2/1s with flying. They're flying men.
Okay.
That can only block creatures with flying.
Okay.
The flavor text tells a story.
Oh my god.
So you want to get all 4 so you can get the story of a woman finding herself. It's a novella.
Oh my god.
It's a ladies' novella.
Oh, like the one. Never mind.
Not like that.
Okay.
The really epic punch. I just think it's the best art. It's a shark bear punching out a dragon.
It's fucking epic.
Right? It's a. It's really epic.
Yeah, it's really.
That's what it says.
Fucking epic.
The shell elephant.
Why is one of those cards facing right and the rest of them are facing left?
Oh. Because that version of Sly Spy, whenever Sly Spy deals combat damage to a player, you may destroy target creature facing right in its art.
Oh, that's messed up.
Well, you may. You don't have to.
Yeah.
All the other Sly Spies face left. Also, each one says what sneak stands for, but none of them agree. Like Sinister Nerds eliminating all knowledge. Or
such association.
Spies nimbly eluding adversaries' knives.
That has the potential to be
an 18/18 creature. Yes. Unless people keep guessing words like idiots. Yeah. Because remember, if they guess a word wrong, you get the +1/+1 as well. So if you're fighting Hangman, guess letters. Don't guess words until you know the word. But if you just start guessing words off the bat, he can go above 18/18.
Ooh.
And actually, you could be a 20/20 if you go with a 6-letter word.
Ooh.
And actually, that's not true. You could be a 21/21.
Ooh.
Now, in Unhinged, there was a card that could get to... With some cloning things, somebody once saw it get to 81/81. Which, 81/81.
Damn.
I think somebody almost got it to 144/144.
What?
It's Snot, and there's a card called Snot that every time you play one, you stack him. And however high the stack is in cards, his power and toughness is that to its own power. Or no, it's that squared. So it's like, 1 is a 1/1, 2 is a 4/4, 3 is a 9/9, 4 is a 16/16, 5 is a 25/25,
etc.
etc. It's all square numbers.
Damn!
Sword of Dungeons and Dragons.
I want that card.
I figured you did.
Because that card gets you a beautiful, shiny gold dragon.
You have the very cryptic command, which comes in different variants, so you don't know which one you're getting. And perhaps the ultimate in not knowing what the damn card says. Urza, the Academy Headmaster. Once again, it is Urza's head.
Uh-huh. He is a headmaster.
Apparently one of the books says sibling rivalry in the back. Because the stories are all about how he fights his brother. You're supposed to go to the website and click on which ability you're using, and it gives them different abilities. Yeah, the Novellamental is... That's the other joke on Novellamental. I didn't
is
say this
Is Jane Eyre the flying dork?
Look.
Jane Eyre.
The flying book.
Oh, flying book. Got it.
But yeah, it's Jane Eyre.
That's funny.
That is actually a very... story. I like that story.
You like Jane Eyre?
I do. I haven't read it. I've watched the English.
I read it.
TV series adaptation of it.
Mm-hmm.
I watched the movie. The movie was good.
I guess it might have been a movie too. Yeah,
mm.
It was.
Two more I'm gonna do, and then we're gonna be done for the night.
Okay.
One is, where did he go? Dr. Julius Jumblemorph.
What the oh my god, what the fuck?
Two and a green white for a legendary creature. 4/4. Dr. Julius Jumblemorph is every creature type. Even if this card isn't on the battlefield. Whenever a host enters the battlefield under your control, you may fetch your library and or graveyard for a card with augment and combine it with that host. If you search your library this way, shuffle it.
I'm sorry, that probably hurt.
A little bit. So he's a 4/4 for 4 that lets you, every time you summon a host, you immediately get to augment it.
Skippy says, pick Zizzix and you're golden.
Not if they know you're going to do that, because you're 3 letters in. Oh, another very, very fun one, actually, before we go on. The Killbots for Mario Kill.
Oh my god!
The Curious Killbot. The delighted killbot, the despondent killbot.
That's great.
Click, click, beep, whirr.
Oh yeah, because wasn't there another card in the set that like said you could exile a creature if you could tell what card it was based on the flavor text,
and the killbots are basically immune to that, unless you are that anal retentive about it.
Click, click.
And the best one out of all of them.
Yeah.
When it comes to doing weird ass shit.
Yeah.
Where did you, here he is.
What is
the countdown is at 1.
Oh.
Players play a magic subgame starting at 1 life and using the libraries as their decks. For the rest of the main game, if a source would deal damage to a player who didn't win the subgame, it deals double that damage to that player instead. So, basically, we're going to play Magic. We're going to stop playing Magic to play Magic real quick. Why did it immediately change to Swamp?
I don't know! But that's fun. It's gained sentience.
Wait. Apparently it identified my arm in the shadows as a swamp.
That's hilarious.
Oh no, but it needed red there. Red, go back to where you were. Anyway, the card recognizer thought I was a swamp, apparently. So, we're just gonna move out of the way of the card recognizer. There we go. So, yes, if you want to...
I'm basically a Muppet.
Huh. I'm wondering about that, actually.
What?
Our Discord widget actually seems to be broken.
Oh,
but,
no!
If you want to hang out with us more, go into our Discord. If you want to make sure you know everything we're doing... Make sure you're following us on Twitch, you're subscribed on YouTube. If you want to, you can support us on Patreon, etc. Oh, and one more important thing. Two more important things, actually. One, we need to make sure that these get into the Krakacube.
Oh, yeah!
Not the vampire. Vampire can stay out.
Vampire goes into Red's deck.
Give me.
And this Ixalan card that snuck its way in.
Because he gave it to me. He put it on my head.
I was testing the card reader with
here,
it.
Here, give me the initiate's companion as well.
Okay. So,
Crack-a-pack.
I don't remember Crack-a-pack cube went.
We're going to go... the Crack-a-pack cube is somewhere.
Somewhere.
I think it's up there.
Okay. We'll put it in there later.
We are still going to do a Crack-a-pack draft at the end of the year with every pack we have cracked.
Cool.
That is the plan.
Yay!
We're gonna do some crazy stuff. It's gonna be fun. If you have particular packs you would like to see end up in that cube. Oh yeah, turn it around. No, look at the back.
I know I did. Isn't it pretty?
Yeah, it's full art. It's great.
Love it!
It's
mine!
All the unhinged tokens are like that. Well, it's the company's, technically. Alright. Anyway, so, if you are...
That'll be censored in the UK.
Will it, though?
Yes.
Will it?
Oh, probably
anyway,
not.
Anyway, we figured out the map. For most recent card packs, if there's a pack you want us to get, it's like 1,000 bits, and you put in what pack you want us to buy, we will just go do it. If you do 2,000, we are pretty much guaranteed to just go get any pack. Except for, I think there's like one pack at the store we go to get sealed product that is like $20 a pack.
Neat.
And I think it's time shift. But the rest of them are between 5 and 10 with Twitch exchange rates. If you have a particular pack you want us to open and you don't know how to get it, you can do it that way. Alternatively, you can stop touching my hair. Alternatively, you can just send it to us, of course. Message us on Discord. We'll help you set that up. Oh, of course, you could also just watch and do it for free, because you are under no obligation to help us. Don't worry about it. Uh-huh. But if you want to help us, we have Patreon. We can also use some Twitch subs. Or just throw bits at us with no messages. We will take whatever you got.
Yep.
Anyway, we will catch you all later on the drafting table. And we will see you with some other streams in the future.
I'm doing
bye,
everybody.
Everyone.
Have a good day.